Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat pagi. Good morning, everybody. So, as I explained before, that why we need communication, because each of us have information to be shared. So what is the information? The information, we can divide the information into three parts. Voice, data, or text. An image. So we have three information that should be shared using telecommunication device. But nowadays all information are converted into data, not converted into analog signal, no, but all of them are converted into file. It means that convert into digital. Before, when you heard, if you heard radio FM, for example, Suara Surabaya, before digital era, the signal are maybe directly transmit to the listener. And sometimes they record it in the cassette recording or disc. But now, all the information are converted into digital, into file, so that they can save, keep it, put it in the server, or make some modification or manipulation of the data. Okay, some example of communication are telegraph, Morse, or telephone, home telephone. Maybe nowadays not many house telephone. You call it PSTN telephone, the telephone from Telkom that on our home. That we have number. So this is the difference between communication, two-way communication, and number communication. Okay, why do you know why the telecommunication have a number? For example, your phone, you have a number. My phone, I have a number. Even WhatsApp, they have a number. Before, the communication is only two ways, only two note. So that if only two note, you don't have to have phone number, no need, because only two people. If only two people communicate, no need number, no need address, no need identity. But when more than two people, the third people, fourth people, five people, six people, and 1 million people, they're connected to a network. So they need number, they need address, so that each address can connect with the same public network. You understand what I mean here? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if you are in a quiet room, quiet area, you can unmute your mic so that you can replay quickly as Fitra Yudhistira. Fitra Yudhistira, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, we continue. Okay. Now I will discuss about the one-way or two-way circuit. What's the meaning by one way or two way circuit? Circuit is the media. Circuit, we can call it like a copper cable, like a copper cable. So some telecommunication system use one way. One way, it means that only like a announcer with the listener. Announcer, penyiar, listener, or only listen. So this is one way. One way is there only one direction. Like if you heard azan is like one way communication. Or if television also is one way communication, television, radio also one. And what is two way? Two way is they use the same circuit to communicate two ways. So that, for example, like you call WhatsApp call, telephone call, it is two way communication. It means that the listener also can speak to the announcer. For example, if television are two ways communication, so the pemirsa, the people who see the television can communicate with the announcer, with the host of the event, the host of the acara program, yeah. So one way circuit is mean that the circuit, the copper, the cable only one way. One way mean that only one direction. But if two ways, so the circuit can be two ways, for example. So, but in fact, it's always one way communication. Why? That's why the cable are two. You see, all cable, minimum two cable, two copper, two line. When you open the cable, have you ever opened the cable of your phone, of your charger?
No, sir.
Okay, open. What about another cable? For example, the cable of the electricity cable at home. Have you ever opened it? Have you ever opened the cable of your television or cable? What else? All cable. If you have
fan. Some of cable, right?
Huh?
It have some of cable. It's not just one cable.
Yes, that's why. Good. So it's minimum two. So
okay.
Usually communication use two circuit. So it's mean that for one for direction, one direction and one to another direction, to vice versa. So if you communicate with two nodes, so one for direction left and one for direction right. So that's why it's two circuit every cable. Some cable are more than two circuit, for example, four circuit. If you open the UTP cable in the local area network cable for computer, you have eight cable. So two cable for direction, for one direction, and two cable for reverse direction, and the other four cable for power supply normally for to transmit the electricity. Okay, the media of communication not only copper. You know copper? Tembaga. Not only copper. Copper is, we call it wired cable, media wired. So they are also wireless. Wireless mean using the air, yeah, udara. So wired can be divided into three media. First, copper, tembaga. Second, coaxial. Have you know coaxial cable? Your television, antenna?
Yeah.
Have you ever open the cable of your antenna at home, your television antenna? So they have, it's have a copper, one copper, and the other like what's it called? Perak, silver, like silver, I don't know what's the name. So in coaxial cable, so we have three kind of wired cable. First, copper, tembaga. Second, coaxial, like your antenna television or TV cable. And the third is optical cable. Optical cable is like a glass. They made from glasses, yeah. Kaca, not from tembaga, not from coaxial. So they make as a glass. So there are also one more. So not three, four. We call it WaveKit. WaveKit is like a cable, but inside of the cable are the empty space, ruang hampa. So this cable, we call it RF cable. We call it RF cable or WaveKit. It means that it is wireless, but they should follow the cable. This cable used in the BTS of telecommunication. If you see the tower of telecommunication BTS in your near your home, if you see the big cable color black color from the antenna to the shelter is the room, white room above the tower. If you see the black, maybe I will show you here. RF cable. Can you see my right here?
Yeah.
Yes, this one. Yes, this one. RF cable. Yes, this one. This one. So inside here is empty space. Inside here is empty space. Can you see this website? Hello?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we call it WaveKit cable. So there are ruang hampa, empty space here, but inside the cable, and the signal is RF. They send inside this cable. So we call it RF cable. Okay, continue. So, and then for the wireless cable, the air, using the air, udara, using the air. So we call it radio frequency. We call it radio. So we call it radio. Radio is the communication, the media of communication that's using air to transmit the signal. So because of that, there are only three kind of signal. First, electronic signal, electric signal. Second, optical signal, light signal, cahaya. So first, signal electronic. Second, optical, light, cahaya, signal. And the third is RF signal. Tembaga, copper, use electronic signal. Coaxial cable, use electronic signal. Optical cable, use lighting signal, signal cahaya, optical signal. And wireless or in the air, use RF signal. Okay. Also, there are also binary digital signal also. So signal can be defined into two: analog signal, which is RF normally, and digital signal. This is like a square signal, like you have done before, digital signal. Okay, now we talk about noise. Now before noise, we talk about what is frequency, what is amplitude, what is binary digital signal. So frequency is the number of one wave, full wave, gelombang penuh. So like a sinus, if you know the sinus signal, sinus, the sinus wave, cosinus or sinus wave, you know sinus? Hello?
Yes, sir. I know. Sinus and sinus wave, yeah.
Okay. Sinus is like this. I will show you. Sinus wave. So this is We call it sinus because it start from zero, like this. Can you see this picture?
Yes, sir.
The sinus is start from zero, like this. But cosinus start from one, okay? I will show you cosinus. Cos. So cos is start from one. See here? They start from one, this one. Okay, start from one, but sinus start from zero. Understand? This is sinus, start from zero. Okay, frequency means one, this one. This is one, frequency one. For example, so if this is the x ordinate, axis is time, and this one is amplitude. Okay, so if to have one full wave, this is full wave, this half wave, it need 1 second, so the frequency is 1 second. If to reach this one, they have, it need 2 seconds, so the frequency will be half hertz. So the unit of frequency is hertz, okay? Understand? The unit.
Yes, sir.
What is the unit of length?
Meter.
Meter, good. So frequency is like that. Okay, we come back here. Amplitude is this one, the power, the level of how big the mountain. Okay, here. This is the amplitude. And the fase is here, the fase. Between this line, green line here, to the horizontal line. This is the fase. Okay, understand? Sudut. Okay? Hello?
Okay. Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is the meaning of frequency? You already know. Amplitude. So in frequency normally used in the wireless, in the air, in the wave, analog wave. That's why every technology have their own frequency. Like Wi-Fi, they have on their own frequency, and also Bluetooth, they have their own frequency. 3G, 4G, they have own frequency. What is it mean that they have their own frequency? Mean like this. So, for example, for 3G, to reach this one, they only need less than 1 millisecond. For 4G, on to reach one wave, they need only 1 million second only. So they have their own frequency. Okay. Okay. Now we talk about noise. What is noise? Do you know noise? Hello?
Yes, sound.
What is noise? Hello?
Hello, sir.
Yes, do you know noise?
Sound wave.
Huh?
Yes, noise is sound, yeah? Sound.
No, noise is not sound. No, noise is not sound. Yes, noise, English term is sound, but in telecommunication, Not the meaning of not sound. Okay, Putri, can you explain what is noise?
I don't know, sir.
Hi. Saya Trafif. Mitra, can you explain what is noise? Okay. Hello, Fitra. Okay, Fitra can hear noise. Okay, noise is something that disturbing. Noise, for example, you are study hard and you heard noise. It means that you have a disturbance from another. For example, you watching television and then your friend or your family disturbing you watching television. We call it noise. Noise that make the quality of the telecommunication not good. If you connect to Wi-Fi, And there another antenna, another pemancar. What is pemancar? Another access point that that make noise to your Wi-Fi. So it's mean we call it noise. Okay, the noise is something that disturbing. Understand? No? Fitra? Hello, Fitra? You understand? Fitra? Okay, Dimas?
Yes, sir.
Dimas? What is Fitra? What is noise? What is noise, Fitra?
Fitra is not here, sir.
Huh?
Fitra is not here.
Ah, Fitra is not here. Okay, who are you?
Rufiki.
Okay, Lufiki, please explain what is noise.
So in telecommunication, noise is a type of disturbance. So yes. For example, if there is another transmitter and your Wi-Fi is a bit like slow, that means there's another interrupt or disturbance. It could be noise.
Yes, good. Or if you have if you communicate with another person by talk, by phone, so if you heard some another sound, another voice, so we call it noisy. Okay. So because it will be at, we will be 9, I will stop four more minutes. I will continue, and I will end this course at 9. Okay, that's why, because of the noise, we need to reduce the noise. Yeah. So noise because of it's happen can be caused by frequency or phase. So when another access point, another pemancar use the nearest frequency with us. For example, Suara Surabaya using frequency 100 MHz. There are another radio using 105. So that can be noise for Suara Surabaya broadcasting. You understand? You understand?
Yes.
About? Okay.
Yes,
yeah, yeah. Okay. So it can be frequency. It can be amplitude also. So, for example, in cellular, if the amplitude of the signal from one antenna, it's almost same with the another antenna. So there can be some noise also. Okay, so noise can be made by, can be happen by frequency, phase, or amplitude. But in digital, there are no noise. Digital, no noise. That's why if you see a digital television in your home, the noise are no. They are connect or not connect only. Okay. So when you communicate with digital communication, so when the information are converted into digital, so it's difficult to have a noise. That is why some technology move to digital, so that to avoid the noise. Also modulation is one method to not avoid the noise, instead of also beside modulation we can send the information far distance. Also they made to avoid the noise. Understand what is the function of modulation? Royce, what is the function of modulation? Modulation is the method to convert the wave of the signal to another wave. The shape of the signal to another shape. Mengubah bentuk dari sebuah signal ke bentuk lain agar so that they can send to far away, far distance. For example, if we don't modulate the signal, when I speak to you, you can hear me in 10 meter only, 10 meter or 20 meter. But with modulation, you can hear my voice for maybe 100 kilometer. For example, I convert it into FM, I modulate the my voice to FM so that it can send to far away. And the second function is for to avoid the noise. Okay, so modulation one to send information far away. Second, to avoid noise. Okay, yeah. Because now at 9, I will end the communication. I will end this class, and I will send the record. And you send the your note. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. See you.
Okay, sir.
Bye bye.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.